Hello, welcome to the European Open Briefing for Thursday, April the 19th. I'm Rafi Berjan, currency analyst at XM.com, and we're going to be having a look at the latest developments in the currency markets today. So we are seeing a slightly stronger dollar this morning. It's being supported by a rise in US Treasury yields. Not just in the US, but other government bond yields have been boosted this morning on possible expectations of higher inflation after oil prices surged to fresh three-year highs yesterday. So that jump in oil prices comes after Saudi Arabia signaled that it would mind seeing crude oil prices reaching $100 a barrel. Sterling is one of the biggest losers this morning. It fell sharply yesterday on weaker than expected inflation numbers and further today on a drop in retail sales. The Canadian dollar is also struggling. Yesterday, the Bank of Canada disappointed those traders who were expecting a more hawkish tone out of the central bank. And the Aussie, despite some weak data out of Australia, is slightly firmer as commodity prices rally this morning. So let's get started with having a quick look at the major pairs and indices. We can see dollar slightly up this morning, dollar yen, well, comfortably above the 107 level. Euro and sterling both lower. Aussie slightly up. Kiwi, though, is slightly weaker on soft inflation numbers. Gold prices are benefiting from the overall rise in commodities despite easing geopolitical risks. Crude oil, though, we can see is extending its gains further this morning, rising by another 1%. Stocks were mixed yesterday in the US, but overall higher energy stocks are boosting both Asian and European indices. Let's take a look now at the US dollar. We can see both dollar index and dollar yen extending their rebound from those lows we saw on Tuesday. Dollar index is seeing a much weaker recovery. Dollar yen is seeing a slightly stronger rebound. It's currently trading around 107.30. It had dropped to 7. That's still some distance from the 7-week top we saw from last week. So the main reason why the dollar is going up, apart from recent strong data, is higher treasury yields this morning. Although the gains are capped, as we still have those lingering concerns of a possible trade war between the US and China. Some relief on the trade front, though, as President Trump didn't really strain his relationship with his key ally, Japan's Prime Minister Shinzo Abe. There is some differences there in terms of what the two sides want in terms of a trade deal between the two nations. President Trump wants a bilateral trade agreement. Japan wants the US to join TPP. But it looks like they just agreed to continue talking rather than escalate trade tensions there. Oil prices now, we can see both WTI crude and Brent crude rising sharply. That rally, though, had begun from earlier in April, and now we're seeing a fresh more than three-year highs. WTI has broken above $69 and Brent crude above $74 a barrel. It comes after reports suggested that Saudi Arabia wouldn't mind seeing oil prices rise as much as $80 or $100 a barrel. This is according to industry sources. Also, Saudi Arabia and OPEC are looking unlikely to make changes to the existing OPEC and non-OPEC deal to cap output. The next review is in June, and this comes even despite the fact that the oil market will probably have rebalanced by then, but they will continue sticking to that deal, which would further tighten the oil market. So that's also boosting oil prices. And also yesterday we saw a drop in US crude oil inventories as well as distillate and gasoline stocks as well. So all of that has all been very positive for oil prices, which is raising concerns that inflation could shoot higher, and that's driving government bonds yields higher, and that's been supportive of the US dollar this morning. If you look at European currencies are both the euro and sterling are struggling. The euro was flirting with the 1.24 level, but now it's dropped to around 1.2367. Sterling, we can see that big drop yesterday after the UK inflation missed expectations. It fell to 2.5% in March versus forecast. It was still unchanged at 2.7. Core inflation also unexpectedly fell instead of rising, and this morning we saw a bigger than expected drop in UK retail sales. That was mainly down to bad weather, but it does raise questions of whether or not the Bank of England will raise interest rates at its policy meeting next month. We can see sterling extending those gains just soon after the UK retail numbers came out. Also possibly weighing on the pound is the some negative developments on the Brexit front. The UK Prime Minister lost, she suffered two defeats in the House of Lords. The House of Lords want the government to change its minds about leaving the EU customs union and also guaranteeing EU citizens' rights, the EU citizens that are living in the UK. But it's that means that the Brexit bill, which those amendments are part of, will now have to go back to the government. Although it's most likely that the government will undo those requests by the House of Lords, so that's not the main concern for the pound at the moment. Moving on to the Canadian dollar, we can see the loonie, it had managed to rise to 7-week highs earlier in the week, reaching 1.2522 to the US dollar. It fell sharply yesterday after the Bank of Canada was a bit more cautious when it came to raising interest rates. The Bank of Canada Governor Stephen Poulos said that although it's very likely that higher interest rates will be warranted over time, he said we can't be definitive about when or at what pace. So the fact that they haven't decided how many times they want to raise rates and when, so that was seen as fairly dovish, and that's why we saw that sell-off for the Canadian dollar. We can see USD CAD jumping by 0.8% to 1.26 60 yesterday, but again, given the recent gains, you could say that it's not looking too badly for the loonie at the moment, especially if we were to get a NAFTA deal very soon. And now let's quickly turn to the Australian and New Zealand dollars. We can see the Aussie did fall earlier today after weaker than expected job numbers out of Australia. We saw the Australian economy adding just 5,000 jobs in March versus forecast of 21,000. But the overall rally in commodity prices helped the Aussie actually briefly top the 0.78 level. It's currently trading just below it. The loonie, though, didn't get as much of a lift from higher commodity prices. New Zealand's inflation rate fell to 1.1% in the first quarter of 2018. That's at the lower end of the RBNZ's target band. And if we do see further weakness, we could potentially see the RBNZ moving towards a rate cut rather than the current position that RBNZ will probably, RBNZ's next move will probably be up. You can see the Kiwi currently trading at around 0.7310 at the moment. And looking at today's economic calendar, it's going to be fairly quiet in the US session with just a weekly jobless claims, but we do have a number of Fed speakers coming up. That's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and have a great day.